Welcome to Wanted Down Under, the show that catapults a British family right across to the other side of the world to help them make the biggest decision of their life, whether to stay in the UK or to move to Australia.
Alan Kappelman lives with his family in Newcastle. He's desperate to start a new life down under.
I would say I was 99.9% certain that I really want to go to Australia.
As a sports teacher, it offers Alan the ideal lifestyle, both in work and leisure.
I hope the lifestyle and the standard of living in Australia will be a great deal better than what it is here.
But his wife Louise isn't keen on uprooting her family.
We're going to lose a lot by leaving, I think. We'll just have to wait and see.
Leaving her loved ones behind is something she'll never get used to.
No, it's going to be harder for her to come over. It's going to be harder for me, I think.
On their trial week down under, Louise digs in her heels.
Well, if you're looking, comparing them, I'm better off in the UK, financially.
No, I'm not going to disagree.
Will this upset Alan's plans to move where they're wanted down under? Australia has long been a destination of choice for Brits looking for a better lifestyle, and it's on the lookout for people with certain skills and experience. If you're under 45 and on the skilled occupations list, which includes anything from nurses and builders to teachers and scientists, you can apply for a visa and ultimately residency down under. But many people underestimate how difficult the move can actually be.
We've given another British family the opportunity to spend a week down under to see if it's all they dreamt it would be. After that, they'll have to make a decision one way or the other, to stay in the UK or to move to Australia.
Alan and Louise Kappelman live in Newcastle with their three children, 5-year-old Laurie, 3-year-old Freya, and Ethan, who's one. Alan is a 43-year-old PE teacher and wants to up sticks and move his family to Australia for a better quality of life.
The reason I want to move to Australia is because I met a couple of Australian PE teachers a couple of years ago, and they talked about how good the lifestyle was in Australia compared to what it is here. So I hope the lifestyle and the standard of living in Australia will be a great deal better than what it is here. I would say I was 99.9% certain that I really want to go to Australia.
Unlike his wife, Alan's already got family living in Melbourne.
It is a lot easier for me because with my parents and family being across there and what she's leaving behind.
Alan's wife Louise is 28 and doesn't share his passion. She has a solid support network of friends and close family who she'd have to leave behind.
I see my mum every day because I drop the girls at school and she looks after Ethan. In the morning, and then we'll go to theirs on a Sunday, the whole family, don't go for Sunday's dinner.
Alan has a son he'd be leaving in the UK.
Adam's 14 years of age. At the moment, he's a 2-minute drive away. It's easy to get to. If he's any concerns, he can always give me a ring, and I'm always there for him, and I always will be there for him.
But he still thinks the move could work out well.
Across in Australia, I'm hoping that I'll actually see more of him, because when he comes over for the 6-week summer holidays, I've got him for 6 weeks. As opposed to 6 days throughout the year, whatever it might be.
It takes an outgoing person to move to Australia and make new friends. Alan might have a lot of persuading to do if Louise is going to come with him.
Louise can be quite shy at times and not quite forceful like that, so that's a concern that I would have for Louise.
If Alan hadn't said anything, I think I'd be quite happy.
I've now really got to try and convince Louise that Australia is the way forward.
In the UK, Alan has a good job as the head of a PE department, and there's a lot to lose by moving.
The setup over here is very good, and most people, I think, would be very happy with it. I've got a good job, I love my job, so there is a bit of sacrifice, but sometimes you take one step back to take two steps forward, and that is one way that I'm looking at it.
I just don't want to go across there, though, and have not as nice a house. Because we're going to lose a lot by leaving, I think. We'll just have to wait and see.
The cut-off for a skilled migrant visa is 45 years of age, so for the Kappelmans, it's now or never.
And by the time the visa process goes through, I'll be 44, nearly 45. So it's probably my last opportunity to get out there.
But this decision is one they've both got to make together.
It's not just about me and my dreams and aspirations, it's about what's going to be useful for the whole family. And if that means that that Louise doesn't want to go, and we've had a good...
That's it.
Yes.
Will Alan and Louise be able to come to an agreement? To help them decide, we're sending them to Perth, the capital of Western Australia. With its relaxed atmosphere, miles of beaches and sporty culture, it's bound to give them and the children the lifestyle they're looking for. And its suburbs should provide options for buying good-sized property on their budget of £225,000. Perth is also home to 5 universities and various further education colleges, meaning Alan will have plenty of opportunities.
We've found 3 possible lifestyles for our family, each one offering a brand new way of life for them to try on their budget. But which one will be the most suitable?
Life on the coast is a world away from what the Kappelmans are used to. With beaches and national parks close by, there are plenty of opportunities for them to spend time together as a family. A 4-bedroom house like this one in Quinns Rock could set you back up to £400,000, well beyond the Kappelman's budget. Further in from the coast, house prices drop to around £240,000, but with fewer work opportunities close by, Alan would face up to an hour's commute to work each day.
So very different from their life in the UK. But what about the second option?
Melville is an outer suburb of Perth and the closest you can get to living in the country, with attractions including a reptile centre and aquariums giving the children a unique opportunity to see wildlife up close. Houses here are expensive, and this 4-bedroom property will set you back over £400,000, smashing the Kappelman's budget. Other houses in the area will be around £330,000. That's still too high for the Kappelman's. And it could involve a 30-minute commute for Alan into work.
But what about the third option?
Living in East Perth would put the Kappelman family right in the heart of the city. Here, they can access anything they want from the central business district, meaning shopping and entertainment are close by, as well as the famous Swan River, should the family want to cruise and sightsee. The average price of a 4-bedroom home here is around £750,000, and the Kappelmans might be hard-pressed to find property within their budget. But there are various schools and colleges within walking distance for Alan.
So 3 very different possibilities for our family to try. So which one did we decide would suit them best?
We're sending the Kappelmans to live on the coast in Carramar. With its sandy beaches and activity-fueled lifestyle, the family should be happy here and find a property on their budget. We've got a job for Alan to try out. Found some properties to show them.
No, it's not right for us as a family, and I think it wouldn't work.
And given them a taste of the Aussie lifestyle, but will it live up to expectations?
Green's coming. Let's go.
And will they decide to stay?
Doesn't matter if you vote UK.
It's time for the Kappelmans to take the plunge. The journey from Newcastle to Perth takes 21 hours, and the family finally arrive in Australia at 5:30 p.m. local time. Alan made this trip before, about 20 years ago, but it's Louise and the children's first time down under.
Australia doesn't feel as far as I expected, you know. We had a good flight, and I think that made a big difference.
Looking forward to bed, a cup of tea in the sun tomorrow morning. Noreen.
They're all excited about the adventures that lie ahead. But will Alan be able to persuade Louise they can build a new life so far from home? The Kappelmans will be staying in Carramar, a northern suburb of Perth, an hour from the city, but just 15 minutes drive to the beach. With 4 bedrooms and a large open plan living area, there's plenty of space for the children. Let's hope the Kappelmans like it.
Come on, girls.
That's nice.
This kind of property would cost around £230,000 and a teeny bit over their budget, but it'll give them an idea of the Aussie style of living.
So what do you think?
The only drawback, I think, with the open plan is the fact that when we're making some meals, the smell's going to be around
the lounge. I know, they're like keeping an eye on the kids there in the living room. It's easier, isn't it?
But thinking about what we have at home, in terms of furniture, I think could quite easily fit into here.
Well, they're off to a good start, and Alan's already moving in. But what about the bedrooms?
It's a little bit bigger than what we've got back home, but it's a little bit smaller than what I thought.
Not too impressed then, but the bedrooms have a few added extras.
See? That's
boring, isn't it? It's a much bigger ensuite, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It's tiled a little bit nicer than ours as well, isn't it?
A lot nicer. It's a lot nicer than you, though, isn't it? That's a nice big bed. Not huge, is it?
It's not. It's not as big as I perhaps thought.
Will the outside be any more impressive?
Okay. Got nowhere for the trampoline or the slides or the It's a tiny garden.
I think we'd want a bigger garden. I think by the time you put your trampoline up, in fact you wouldn't get your trampoline up, would you?
So what's the verdict on their rental accommodation?
One of the reasons that we want to move here is that we want the kids on the outdoors. You look at the size of the garden, it's not very spacious, so they are going to be in here.
Why do you we wouldn't get this? Because we want a bigger garden, don't we?
We'd need a bigger garden.
Let's hope the Kappelmans feel a little bit more at home tomorrow.
I think after seeing this house, it would be very interesting to see what we can actually get for our budget. And that's important. Make sure we've got that sorted out by the end of the week.
Alan already knows he wants to move down under, but he's got to convince Louise.
What's really important is that we use this week to try and convince you that Perth will be right for all of us as a family.
I just need to see what it's like. It's not convincing, is it?
Seeing
what it's like.
Okay.
Louise is keen to make her own decision.
Yeah, I think this week's going to decide a lot of things, isn't it? Whether we stay or go.
Absolutely.
Let's hope the Kappelmans can come to an agreement. Back in the UK, the Kappelmans live in a four-bedroom detached house, which they believe to be worth around £245,000. In Australia, they're looking for a four-bedroom, two-bathroom property and have a budget of up to £225,000, so we found them three properties to look around. First up is a four-bedroom house which is on the market for around £220,000 and well within their budget, but will they like it? Well, it's not the grand open-plan entrance hall Alan may have been expecting.
It's a nice room, it's a bit small. I'm not too sure about going straight in from the outside, straight into what could be the living room. I don't know.
The master bedroom's so big, there's even room for a desk, so maybe that'll please him.
It's nice. It's bigger than ours, yeah.
Ensuite's not huge, though, is it?
No, it's nice. It'll do. There's a walk-in wardrobe.
A walk-in wardrobe? Come on, Louise, that must tick a box. Unimpressed with the master bedroom, maybe they'll like the space of the traditional Aussie family room.
Oh, this is nice.
Oh, no, this is more like it, isn't it? I like the space in here.
Finally, this is the kind of thing they want.
Have we got the unit space compared to what we have already?
Maybe not as much. I think the living room's nice size. Nice big. There's enough room for the kids to play. Big windows as well. Got a light.
But with a nice sized living area, there seems to be a compromise in the bedrooms.
This room's a little bit smaller than what I expected, to be honest. It's similar. It's very similar to what we have at home.
A bit bigger than what we've got. Plus all the wardrobes are.
I don't know if they're any bigger than what we've got, though. I don't think they are.
Yeah, but we've got our wardrobes on built in.
Will the outdoor living area make them see this property differently?
No, this is more like it.
Yeah, I can quite easily see myself on a Saturday afternoon, open up a few glasses and a bit of a barbecue.
Cook.
Yeah, fantastic. Definitely Saturday afternoon, this.
Ah, yes. To top it off, there's a pool.
A swimming pool.
That's what you wanted, isn't it? It's a nice garden, isn't it?
Fantastic. This is about why you wanted to come to Australia, I think.
So this property seems like it's got big potential.
I think the inside's a little bit smaller than what we already have, and I think you would see that in the unit space for the kitchens and what have you.
I think this is like fine for just us. Yeah, it's what we need.
I totally agree.
Until you've got a job sorted and everything.
I think the good thing is that we could afford this ourselves. But like I say, I think it would be nice...
To see what we could possibly get.
But Alan has bigger and better plans. He's considering asking his Melbourne-based parents to invest in a property with them.
It'd be really interesting to see that what we could get if perhaps, you know, the possibility of clubbing together with my parents and what have you, and see what size property we could get for that. Yeah, I think that's really that would be interesting.
If he can persuade his parents to invest, they could afford a much more luxurious property from the start. But there's a small catch. His parents would be leaving Melbourne and moving in with them. To give them a taste of what could be achievable if they all club together, we found property number two. It has four bedrooms and extra reception rooms. Is valued at £310,000 and could be theirs, with a bit of help from mum and dad.
Oh, now this looks nice, doesn't it? Ah, this is nice, isn't it? Nice and spacious.
Nice size.
Yeah. The ensuite's quite nice. It's similar size to the last one. Double shower, nice big double shower there.
First impressions are good, but they'd need space for Alan's parents.
You know, I'm thinking about that second budget. If my parents were here, you know, there's a possibility that perhaps this room could be used for my parents as a bedroom or a lounge for them.
Oh yes, every woman's dream, having the in-laws living in the front room.
Yeah, if the house is big enough, yeah. I mean, I think you were thinking more of ergonomics, weren't you, for a separate building or something.
It's something to think about.
This cinema room would work for most film buffs, but it doesn't do it for Alan.
One of the real ideas of reasons why you want to come to Australia is for the outdoor stuff, and don't know, this room hasn't convinced me for that reason, and I think it could be better spent. Yeah, even a playroom. I don't want them like the UK, sat in the house watching DVD after DVD and what have you.
End of rant. Don't go on, Dad.
Ethan's just falling asleep.
We know to buy one. Of
Louise is loving the luxurious space and decor, but there's only one room that really impresses Alan.
Oh yes, the best room of the house so far, I would say. I quite like this room.
But she has other ideas.
I'll probably have a bigger kitchen and have it more of like a day room or something for the kids.
With luxury additions and room to spare, this is a lot of house for £310,000, but it isn't quite what Alan and Louise are looking for.
If you're going to stretch your budget, then you want big rooms, and I'm yet to find one, really.
Will the outdoors area change their mind?
Nice pool.
Beautiful. It's a pool, isn't it? Imagine just sitting around there in an afternoon, enjoying the sun. It's nice. It's not child-friendly in any way.
It's a lovely pool. It's just not for me. I like grass. A bit more grass. It's like something you get in the hotel.
That looks fantastic, isn't it? But no, it's not right for us as a family, and I think if we're considering stretching the budget to this amount...
I thought I'd get something much bigger.
It wouldn't work.
I preferred the other one.
It seems like Louise would prefer a place of her own, and Alan's parents can keep their wallets closed for now. We're going to show them their final property, which they should be able to afford on their own. Property 3 is on the market for £235,000. It's slightly over the Kappelmans' budget, but not unachievable, depending on what they could get for their house back in the UK. With four bedrooms, a stylish modern design and a pool, could this be the one?
Nice room.
Very big.
It's not very big. Plenty of light. It's not as dull for you as one or two others, perhaps.
Too small again. Apparently, with Alan, size is everything. Will the bedrooms be more impressive?
Quite nice size.
Nice size, yeah.
Oh, nice wardrobes for me.
Just what? Yeah. And for me.
It's a nice bathroom.
It's probably the best one we've seen so far on the ensuite.
They seem to like the ensuite too, but there's a small problem with the layout.
Here's the bedrooms right at the front of the game.
It's a nice window, like the archie, because normally they're all just straight up and down the square, aren't they?
Yeah, that takes away a bit of privacy though, doesn't it?
It's nice and bright.
Possibly the best we've seen so far, I think.
It is. Nicest inside, isn't it?
The large open plan living area also ticks some boxes.
It's a big dining room, isn't it?
It's a nice dining room.
This house's wooden floors and minimalist design are doing their job. This is looking more promising.
I like the floor, the polished floor, it's really nice.
And on further viewing, Alan's decided there's a bit more space than he originally thought.
The rooms are definitely bigger, aren't they? The other two.
Okay.
I think this is potentially the best inside house that we've seen so far, yeah. Yeah. Good little room, this.
So what about outside?
There's no grass though.
No, but the kids will be happy in the swimming pool. That's fantastic. Lovely little forest square. Nice little area.
Nice, but I still like grass.
You still like grass?
But a nice, this is a right-sized house.
You'd be happy with this type
happy
of house,
happy with this, with a bit of grass in the garden. I still think I like the outside of the first one, first house.
The first house outside was just absolutely perfect, wasn't it? And I like the inside here, so we'd have to compromise on a balance there somewhere.
Property 3 seems to be a hit. The Capplemans have seen three prospective houses. Property 1 was within their budget of £225,000, and although they liked the living space and outdoor area, they'd have to compromise with small bedrooms.
This one's a little bit smaller than what I expected, to be honest.
Property 2 was a lot pricier and certainly had the wow factor, but Louise would have to share with the in-laws.
You know, there's a possibility that perhaps this room could be used for my parents as a bedroom or a lounge for them.
And the outdoor space wasn't to their taste either.
It's not right for us as a family, and I think it wouldn't work.
Property 3 was right on budget and seemed to offer a good compromise, with its nice clean design, open spaces and good-sized rooms.
Possibly the best we've seen so far, I think.
But Louise would have to make do with a yard out back.
Nice, yeah. But I still like grass.
So, did the Capplemans find the dream home they were looking for?
I did a lot of research on house prices before coming out, so I've had a pretty fair idea about the price of the houses that we've looked at. The quality of the houses is better than what I actually thought and what I'd researched and what I'd heard and read. And I think the design of the house has probably impressed Louise more than I expected. So I think that's a good thing, for me certainly anyway. I would like to think that what we've seen today has been enough to influence our vote. How she'll vote, I really don't know. But I hope it's showing the Australian flag.
Has Louise been impressed enough to vote the way he wants?
We've had a fantastic day. Looked at three very nice houses. In terms of value for money, we are going to vote for... Australia!
So, despite a few misgivings, Alan and Louise like some of the properties. And it's Alan's job that will get them their visa, so he needs to find good work in Australia.
Back in the UK, Alan is the head of physical education at this school in Newcastle.
I have a real passion for my job. I have some great staff that work with me, and the kids can be challenging at times, but really quite receptive as well. It's a fantastic job. It's something that you don't wake up in the morning and think, oh, I've got to go to work. I'm also involved with it, with something that I've loved all my life and really been involved with, and that's what I want to remain in.
He earns around £43,000 a year and has great prospects of moving up the career ladder. But he's willing to give all this up for a better work-life balance down under.
One of the biggest problems is going from head of faculty to perhaps taking a step or two down. And my wife's biggest concern is whether I'll manage to cope with that. But, you know, I think what's important is that I don't become too arrogant. I do have experience within the sport and health, but it's a new national curriculum across there. It's something that I need to come to terms with. And I don't see any reason why within a couple of years I can't be trying to get back to the level, the standard that I'm at the moment.
Alan is heading off for a day's work at the local secondary school. He knows this could be the make or break for his family.
It's basically essential that if we come to Australia, that I can find work. And this morning hopefully will give me a good opportunity to find out whether that is possible.
He wouldn't start as head of department, so may have to take a salary cut, and he's not getting any younger.
In the UK, at 43, 44 years of age, I would find it very difficult to pick up employment as a PE teacher, and I'm wondering whether I would have the same concerns over here.
But the Australian commute is already getting Alan going.
I'm feeling very excited this morning. It's been a sort of pleasure driving in this morning with the sun shining and what have you. And I'd be really interested in a number of things. So I'm quite excited this morning.
Alan's going to be shown around by Simon Young, the head of PE at Hale Grammar School. With 1,000 pupils, this school is a lot bigger than Alan's used to back home. The curriculum is heavily geared towards sport and has an enviable array of top-class facilities. The Australian rugby team even trains here. Alan will have to prove himself if he's to get a job somewhere like this.
I've got this, so we're very fortunate.
He thinks he's going straight for an interview, but Simon has other ideas. He's going to drop the new kid in at the deep end.
We're going to try and convince Alan today that footy should be Aussie rules and not soccer, okay? And we're also going to throw him in and see how he goes with you guys, okay?
Unfortunately, Alan's left his PE kit at home.
No, the left hand.
Let's hope his moves are as silky as his shirt.
Yeah, that's much better.
A couple more and then we'll go to some kicking.
So give yourself a couple of steps. Alan, keep your eyes that way and your hands out in front of your face. Good luck.
Concentrate, Alan. Don't let us Brits down.
Good start. Don't hide at the back.
Oh, yeah, I'll just catch whatever comes my way.
Nice. Alan's got to grips with a new kind of football.
Righto, jogging, fellas.
In Australia, sport is at the heart of young people's education, and Alan is keen to quiz Simon on its importance.
How much PE does his student have per week?
They do probably 8 to 10 hours per week.
8 to 10 hours a week, that's just absolutely amazing. It's fantastic.
A lot of it for us is culture. The boys want to do it, so they're all pretty serious and competitive about their sport. So.
Yeah.
As Simon and Alan get more acquainted, Louise is taking in the local attractions and getting some shopping in. Louise has the chance to reflect on the move and she's still not convinced.
So what's in the next one?
Australia's, it's a lot more spread out, I think. I thought there'd be more places to walk to, from what I've seen. You have to get in the car to go everywhere.
She wouldn't work to begin with, so could be left literally holding the babies.
Alan's main argument is that it's much better life for the kids, which sort of makes me feel like I should come across. But obviously I've got my friends and family to think about, so it's whether I can live over here without them, look after 3 kids on my own.
But she's willing to keep an open mind.
What's the fashion like over here?
I suppose because over in the UK it's more sort of your big sort of department stores, whereas over here it's more your little boutique sort of style. So every little place is different. There's, you know, if there's a certain style that you're after, I'm pretty sure you'd be able to find it in Perth.
Apart from the shopping, Louise has lots on her mind.
The whole thing really rests on whether he can get a job, because if he can't really come over. Same with selling the house prices and things, financial reasons.
Although Louise is still unsure, Alan's been working hard to try and persuade her.
if the kids love it, maybe I should come across.
I don't know.
So, yeah, a lot of things to think about, I think.
Alan needs to find out what he could earn in Australia to see if he and Louise could afford the move.
In the UK, a PE teacher with responsibilities like myself would take me up to, say, £43,000, $86,000. How does that compare with the Australian wages?
So entry point would probably be $50,000.
£25,000, yeah?
Yeah, so, okay. And then probably climbing to $70,000, $75,000.
Yeah.
And then if you're in middle management like me, then you're looking at 75 plus, probably maxing at about, depends where you are, but yeah. Going to sort of in excess of 100 around that mark. Right.
Alan may have to take a salary cut to start with, but he could forge a good career in Australia.
From what I've seen, he's pretty enthusiastic and pretty motivated guy, and I think he'd be a wonderful asset for any school in England or Australia. I don't think Alan would have any trouble adapting to the Australian way of life. I think he's a PE teacher. He obviously loves his sport, which we do. So I have no doubt that he would he'd really enjoy his time over here.
That's just what Alan wanted to hear.
I think Simon's given me some good indications that there will be work here, although nothing can be confirmed at this stage. And that my experiences, mainly athletics and football, would certainly be welcomed in Australia and Western Australia. And that's a nice thing to hear.
I wonder how he'll vote.
I've had a fantastic morning. My concerns about age, my lack of experience in Australian football and salaries have all been answered. And for that reason, the country I'm going to vote for is Australia.
The Kappelmans love the active outdoor lifestyle, and Australia is one of the best places in the world to take up sport.
Australia is a successful sporting nation, and their willingness to try all sports and be great at them makes them the envy of many worldwide. Some would even call them sports crazy.
It's just part of what we do with good weather, and so we spend a lot of time outdoors one way or another. And we also have a lot of infrastructure in place. And infrastructure, I also include parks and gardens and those sorts of things. So we have a lot of open space.
So what role does the PE teacher play in Australia's sporting success?
We have dedicated physical education teachers. And that's important because if children learn the right way to run, the right techniques, then you should practice the right way. And so they get taught all these things at a very early age.
Ron even believes that sport can help a family like the Kappelmans settle in Australia.
Sporting clubs are certainly a terrific way in Australia of meeting people, as are the schools that your children will go to. There are great places to be able to meet people in the community and quickly become a part of the community.
Alan Kappelman is convinced that a new life in Australia will be better for him and his family.
I would say I was 99.9% certain that I really want to go to Australia.
But his wife Louise just isn't convinced.
If Alan hadn't sort of said anything, I think I'd be quite happy.
I've now really got to try and convince Louise that Australia is the way forward.
A look around some properties was generally positive.
I think this is like fine for just us. Yeah, it's what we need.
I totally agree.
So you've got a job sorted and everything.
And Alan fell in love with the job he tried.
I think Simon's given me some good indications that there will be work here, and that my experiences, mainly athletics and football, would certainly be welcomed in Australia and Western Australia.
But it's not all plain sailing. It turns out to be more expensive than they'd hoped.
So if you're looking, comparing them, we're better off in the UK, financially.
No, I'm not going to disagree.
And leaving loved ones behind is never easy.
Sorry. You upset me, Mum.
By the end of the week, they'll have to choose one way or the other, whether to stay in the UK or to move to Australia. But will Louise come round to Alan's way of thinking?
Australia seems to have some great opportunities for Alan, But if they want to make the move, they have to be realistic about their finances. They'll need to get a good price for their house back in Newcastle.
Alan and Louise bought their four-bedroom house back in 2001 for £106,000. They now believe it to be worth around £245,000, but will it be worth as much as they think? We sent round three estate agents to give a more recent valuation.
Smallish dining room off the
main hall.
Yeah, nice room. It's a big table in here, which makes it, gives it the impression that it's a little on the small side.
But nicely decorated. Nice.
Windows look to be recently done as well. Yeah, it's a really, really nice room.
Okay, this is the lounge area.
Very well presented, nice decoration, fireplace, laminate flooring.
Clean and nice and extended over to the rear.
What you class as a sunroom, I suppose, which is great for families.
I like this extension.
Nice and bright, neutral colours. Yes, this will definitely add value to the property.
So this is the kitchen. Very nice. High gloss work surfaces, breakfast bar, fitted appliances.
Yeah, nice kitchen leading to utility area. Possibly could have made better use of this space.
Decent-sized bedroom and decorated fairly neutrally. They haven't overcommitted on it being a child's bedroom, so yeah, I think it
keeps it fairly neutral and should keep the majority of buyers happy.
All right, so this is the smallest room of the property. Well presented again, used currently as a toy room, but make an ideal study.
Good.
Good-sized third bedroom. Radiator. Looking onto the gardens.
It's very nice.
Master bedroom with built-in wardrobes leading to an ensuite. It's nice, nicely decorated.
The property is a four-bedroom detached property with their ensuite.
Built roughly 2000-2001. It's very close to good hospitals, schools and transport links. Very popular area. I would expect this property to achieve somewhere in the region of 225 to 230. And for a quick sale, I would say 215,000.
As an asking price, I would recommend something in the region of around about 220, I would have said.
For a quick sale, I'd value it to 210 to 215.
Those valuations were a lot less than they'd hoped. So how will it affect their ability to move?
I'm not surprised, but I'm still a little bit disappointed in hearing 220, 210, especially for a quick sale.
I think it would be silly to sell it now, when, I mean, they probably are going to go back up.
So based on what we've just seen and heard, you would be less convinced about making the move over here based on the 210, 215, possibly even 220 mark. Whereas if we were to sell it for more than that, it might influence your decision.
Well, if we could get a bigger house, maybe. But I'd still rather rent it out. So we'll have that in case we do come over and it doesn't work.
Something to fall back on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The reality of how much their house is worth has dented the Kappelmans' plans. They'll need to take a closer look at their entire finances to see if they can afford to live down under.
We've prepared a comparison between their living expenses in the UK and in Australia to find out which leaves them better off.
Life insurance. More expensive,
more
that's a bit of a surprise.
Some things seem to be less expensive.
There's a massive difference in the council tax there. You know, £150 a month we're paying, and you're looking at £500 per year. That's about a third of the cost of what we pay per year. So there's a massive saving going to go on there.
The groceries aren't as cheap as they imagined.
More for food in Australia. Everyone's got the perception that Australia's cheaper.
I think the only thing that surprised me is that the food is possibly more expensive, but I don't think they have a competition for you know, selling and buying the food. I don't think there's a great deal of difference.
And I just think from what we've seen, the majority are pretty much the same as what we pay, and fewer more. Plus your wage. Your wage is going to be slightly lower even to start with. You might get up to what you're on now, but you're going to start lower.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to make a massive difference. So at the minute, we're better off. Plus we don't have to buy new cars, the cost of moving. So if you're looking, comparing them, we're better off in the UK, financially.
I'm not going to disagree.
And there are lots of hidden extras of moving that perhaps Alan hasn't faced up to. But is this enough to sway his vote?
Having had the house valued, comparing prices over here and in the UK, for the reality check, we're going to vote for... UK.
So it looks like Louise is starting to make Alan face the realities of a move down under.
This has been her round, if you like, and she sees this as a way of saying, look, we are better off in the UK.
But how much will Louise's opinion count?
I think he's still determined to come, regardless. I think he's quite happy to gamble, whereas I'm a bit more reserved. I'm a bit scared of selling up and coming over and him not getting a job, which I don't think is really past his, I think he's thought about at all, really. I think he thinks he'll just get supply work or something. It might work, it could work. He's a bit more laid back, I think, than me. I'm more of a worrier, I think, probably.
I've been trying all week to convince Louise, and I thought I'd more or less got there until today.
Louise is still undecided about the move, but a major selling point is the Australian lifestyle, so we've sent them out to get a taste of it.
Within Perth, there are 18 parkland areas, which means the family should be able to get out and explore as often as they like. Alan's trying to convince Louise that outdoor life is better in Oz, but it's not quite working out.
Green's coming. Let's go.
You do have to be prepared for some classic British weather. This isn't what the Kappelmans came halfway round the world for, but nothing can dampen Alan's enthusiasm.
Just like England.
You've got to expect a bit of rain, can't we?
Colder than I thought it would be. Should have brought some jumpers for the kids.
Yeah, and I think I'll bring my rain jacket out next time. Yeah.
Could this be another reason for Louise to stay at home? Or is she starting to see the brighter side of life down under?
The lifestyle in Australia is obviously much better than over in England because you can get out. It's been raining, but it's not freezing. Don't get that freezing cold wind that we get.
She knows Alan will be out at work to start with and she'd be left home alone.
I think I am under a bit of pressure to sort of to come over because I know here how much he wants to do it. And I think it probably is better for the kids. Yeah, I do like it. It's just whether I can actually adapt and make the move and be on my own with the kids, with like no support at all.
Despite Alan's persistence, Louise is determined to make up her own mind.
I think Alan's convinced I will vote to come here. I'm still not sure. I'll just have to ponder on that one, but I don't know. See. Mm-hmm.
So, on Australian lifestyle, how are they going to vote?
We've had a great day out, a little bit cold, but also a little bit of sunshine. So we've decided that the country we're going to vote for is...
Australia!
Ethan's throwing his toys out of the pram, but how will Louise deal with her final decision?
So Louise could be coming round to the idea of emigrating, but if you move to the other side of the world, you leave all your friends behind. So how easy will it be to make new ones in Australia?
The Kappelmans have come to meet David and Janet Green. David is a teacher who emigrated to Perth 2 years ago. They're having the classic Aussie barbecue on the seafront, and their kids make friends straight away.
So we were out here 20 years ago.
Right.
Myself and Janet, and I always wanted to come back. I just thought it was fantastic here.
Yeah.
It's just the lifestyle for the kids and that sort of thing.
Your situation just seems to be exactly the same as mine. I was here 20 years ago in Melbourne, and I loved it, wanted to come back, and it just didn't happen for one reason or another.
As Alan and David compare notes, Louise wants to know how quickly Janet settled.
So have you found you just fit in all right over here?
Yeah, I mean, there's always an adjustment period.
Yeah.
And I do occasionally feel that I miss people back home. But I think generally, I think our way of life is a lot nicer. We're a lot more relaxed. We actually spend more family time together.
That's exactly what Alan wants. So how did either of them find work?
And I dropped my resume off as a relief teacher and Janet's resume off as somebody who can help out in the offices if required in administrative work. That night I got a phone call and I got all excited thinking I got my first bit of paid work.
Yeah.
And no, it wasn't for me, it was for my wife Janet. she started the work and I started the beach.
It seems Janet and David both landed on their feet.
It didn't take long after the first, probably like 2 or 3 weeks, got some work and it's amazing how quickly it picks up.
Yeah.
And the good thing for us is that most of the relief coordinators are always begging for good phys ed teachers.
Wow, David's really selling it to Alan, but he doesn't need any more convincing.
OK, guys, you want to come over and get some food? Ladies?
Can Janet persuade Louise Australia's the best place for the kids to grow up?
Our two went just more active and it's just a really good opportunity for them and a really good start, I think.
If that wasn't enough to convince her, the Greens' children, Sam and Charlie, have a go themselves.
When we got here, the people who are our friends now kept on asking us to play with them and sit next to them in class.
On the first day.
And they're like really friendly.
Laurie, Freya and Ethan would have no trouble meeting new friends. So it's all down to Louise.
I think when somebody isn't fully convinced, it's always difficult for the party that does want to take on the adventure. But I think Louise seems quite open to it, even though she does need a bit more convincing.
Sam, Charlie, come on!
They've already made new friends, but has it converted Louise?
I think speaking to Janet's put my mind at rest about coming over and not sort of being alone. I think we probably would adapt quite well. It's obviously easy to meet people, and everyone here seems really friendly. I think once you do get to know people, it's going to be easier to find the areas you want to be in, find good schools, and just they seem to have a lovely family life. They seem to have more time to spend with the family, and I think that's what we want.
Thank you very much.
Alan feels he's done everything he can, and now it's up to her.
I don't think really now it's about convincing Louise. I think it's just going to be a case of, does Louise want to come over? Does she want to make the move? Does she want to commit herself to leaving her family and friends behind? If she can make that move, then I think we'll be across here next year.
So, on making new friends, how will the Kaplemans vote?
It's been a great morning having a barbecue in the park there. We've met a lovely family who were in a similar situation to us 2 years ago, had a great time. So, for that reason, the company that we've decided to vote for is...
So Louise is starting to think that a move down under might just work. But before the Kaplemans make their final decision, they've got to remember who they'll be leaving behind.
We've prepared some messages from their friends and family back in the UK.
Hi, Alan and Louise. Laurie, Freya, Nathan.
Hope you're having a lovely time over there.
Louise, Alan, the kids are a very noisy family.
It's always chaos, but really good fun at the same time.
The two girls are almost kamikaze. They're not like the other grandchildren. They're very rough and tumble. Their dad, being PE teachers, brought them up to run, jump, skip, and they're generally fairly rowdy children, the pair of them, but good as gold, really.
He's a bit of a charmer, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a bit of a charmer and a bit of a, shall we say, a bit of a Del boy.
He tells you one thing but does another.
But he's got a heart of gold. Deep down, he's a lovely person.
Yeah.
Louise is a lovely person.
She's quite shy around people she doesn't know. She's very gentle, caring, and she'll do anything to help anybody out.
When she first told me about going to Australia, I was quite excited for her.
Because a bit of us would absolutely love to go myself. And you never know, next year.
I wouldn't mind going too.
I understand their rationale why they want to go to Australia. It's because they want to have a better lifestyle for the children. And she feels that she maybe should get more from somewhere like Australia than she would get from the UK.
They've been talking about going to Australia for a few years now.
And at first, I wasn't sure it was a good idea. Mainly because she's away from all her family, her friends. Obviously, she's got three very young children.
And she does get a lot of help from her family and friends.
It's a long way to travel on a regular basis. But it's up to them to make their own minds up. I think that's fair, and I wouldn't like to influence them really too much. But obviously, we would miss them very much.
From a selfish point of view, I don't want them to go to Australia.
I'm very close to Louise and the children as well. And I
sort of miss having them around and just being able to call in whenever I've got a spare 5 minutes just for a quick coffee.
The first few months we'd miss them at the table, so you know, it'd be quite a wrench.
And Louise and Caroline also are quite close, so I think it would be a strange thing to feel. The family unit had just suddenly shrunk so much.
I'll miss the girly chats with Louise, I'll miss the phone calls.
I'll miss the clothes borrowing, and obviously I'll miss the kids to bits.
My mum's kind of hoping they won't go.
I think she thinks they'll hopefully come back and decide it's not for them, because I don't think
she'd know what to do with herself if they went over there.
The thought of, you know, the children sort of growing up, you know, without us. Sorry.
We're missing you lots back here,
and I'm missing the kids especially. We'll love you lots, and we'll see you soon.
I hope it's all gone nicely for you.
And remember, we're waiting at home for you. See you soon. You upset me, Mum.
It's a difficult one, isn't it? You know, actually hearing them talk about you in that way makes things, I don't know, a little bit more difficult.
I don't know, it would be harder for you to come over. It's going to be harder for me, I think. I mean, friends-wise. Obviously, my mum's upset by it.
I don't think there's been anywhere that I've gone this week and not thought about Adam as well, about how much he would be really keen to have, you know, been around and been seeing some of the things and hearing some of the things that we've seen and heard this week. But, you know, your mum and dad, perhaps, and financially, in a year or so of time, won't need to work and can quite easily come over and spend longer periods of time over here. I would like to think that in a year or two time, if we were over here, then they would certainly start to consider making the move themselves. And I think that's perhaps a conversation that we need to have with them when we go back to the UK.
It's almost time for the Kappelmans to make their final decision. Their week down under has brought the reality of a possible move into focus.
Alan will be worried if it's changed my mind about staying here or going. I think it probably has. I think I'm probably back to 50-50.
It means a lot to me, and I think it would mean a lot to the kids.
But if Louise does say no, then it's difficult. I really don't know. Once we leave and she goes back to the UK, perhaps she might reconsider.
The Cappelman's week in Australia has been a real mixture of highs and lows. They quite liked the properties.
I think this is like fine for just us. Yeah, it's what we need.
I totally agree.
Until you've got a job sorted and everything.
And Alan loved his job prospects.
There will be work here. And my experiences, mainly athletics and football, would certainly be welcomed in Australia and Western Australia.
But the cost of moving proved a little more than they'd hoped.
And I just think from what we've seen, at the minute we're better off. Plus we don't have to buy new cars, the cost of moving. So if you're looking, comparing them, we're better off in the UK, financially.
No, I'm not going to disagree.
And for Louise, leaving her mum and family so far away would be a real wrench.
Don't upset me, Mum.
But it's time for the final vote.
We've had a fantastic week in Australia. We've certainly been made very welcome. The country that we decided to vote for is...
Australia!
On a temporary basis. For a month.
What made you make the decision? The final decision?
Laurie wanted to stay here, I think.
Mind.
But...
No
not
buts.
Forever.
How'd... There's nothing much I can say, really.
So the Cappelmans were united in the end. Let's hope it works out for the both of them. Join us again next time when we find out what happens when another British family are wanted down under.
Up the news headlines, finding one of Britain's empty homes could be the perfect move for first-time buyers keen to create a property with that wow factor. Searching for cash in the attic in half an hour is a gamble worth celebrating on BBC One.